الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد، أحبتي في الله، continuing our study of Sheikh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab al-Wasabi rahmatullah alayhi rahmatin wasi'a, his treatise, advice for the student of knowledge. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us and him, guide us and guide those who are listening, and have mercy upon the Sheikh and bless him with Jannatul Firdaws. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. He mentioned as his seventh piece of advice, which is something which is immense, and in fact we should probably give it its haq by going into detail, but we'll try to be a bit concise with his treatise as well. He said, be far away from the people of innovation and their books, and evil scholars and their books. So he said, this is also part of advice he gives to the student of knowledge, that they should take their knowledge from the ulama and people of Ahl Sunnah. That you should know who you're taking your knowledge from. As Imam Ibn Sirin mentioned in a famous ether on him, you know, that verily knowledge is your deen. So look to those who you take your deen from. So this is a very important ether to showing us the importance of taking your knowledge from sound sources, and from the people of khair, and from the people of sunnah, that are known for sunnah and known for adhering to the book and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and calling to the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, not calling to hizbiyah, not calling to just blind partisanship to a particular individual or particular individuals or particular groups, particular sects, particular organizations, whatever the case may be, or some sort of bid'ah, or a lot of doubtful things that you find in their speech, and things that they're, you know, like they don't speak about tawheed, or they think tawheed is secondary, or in fact not as important as social problems, or whatever the case may be in their da'wah, or they're very modern in their approach, meaning modern that they're compromising the tenets of Islam in order to refine, as they believe, or reform the approach to the Islamic text. So it's very important to be away from the people of Ahl Bid'ah, the people of innovation and desires, their books, and so on and so forth. And then he said, because Allah the Glorified and Almighty says, follow the path of the one who turns to me. And the Prophet said, the thing I fear most for my nation is a hypocrite with a knowledgeable tongue. Subhanallah. May Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala protect us from that trait. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from those people. Wa'iyadu billah wa iyyakum min kufr, shirk, wa nifaq. And so, ahabati fillah, it shows us the importance of not being deceived by someone, their how articulate they are, or how friendly they seem, and how nice their lectures are with smiles, and you know, whatever the case, your criterion, how entertaining they are, their entertainment value, because those aren't the things, those aren't the criterion for saving you from the fire. Those aren't the criterion for bringing you closer to Allah Azza wa Jalla. So you want to look to those who are bringing you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that they are encouraging you to practice your Islam and teaching you your Islam and teaching you according to the methodology of the Salaf as-Salih. How did the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een, you know, what were the things, what were the creed and the madhab, the understanding of the Sahaba to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een? What was their manners, and what was the manners of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? All of those things that we need to consider and look for, those are the things that should concern us, ahabat tifilah, and in choosing who we take our knowledge from. He then goes on to say, rather Allah the Almighty says, O you who believe, most surely many of the rabbis and monks eat away the property of men falsely and turn them from Allah's way. So it shows that people of knowledge, even in the prior ummas, that they you know, they used to take the wealth of the people in falsehood, and they would turn them away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you want to be taking your knowledge from those who are going to bring you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, remind you of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, and help you to practice and follow the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And we'll keep it brief there until the next sitting. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.